Hello students, in circular motion we will try to study what is meant by centripetal acceleration. Let's go for understanding centripetal acceleration by using actual animation. Here on the screen we find that the particle is performing circular motion. That blue vector shows the radius vector and the red shows velocity vector. We actually find that radius vector is perpendicular to velocity. The magnitude of radius and the magnitude of velocity both are remaining same here. However, the vectors are changing their directions at every instant of time. So let's go for the next part. Here I find a part of that. Here actually I find V1 or VI is the initial velocity, VF is the final velocity, RI is initial radius vector position and RF is the final radius vector position. There is a very small time delta t which we allow in which all these things are happening. The radius changes from RI to RF and velocity changes from VI to VF. Now what I do is to try and understand the vector positions, I consider VI vector which is parallel and equal in magnitude here, VF its parallel vector is taken into consideration here because parallel vectors in magnitude they are equal. Then similarly, actually if I use the triangle law of vector addition, I will find here in this blue triangle RI plus delta R is equal to RF. So delta R vector will be equal to RF minus RI. That's what I find. Here I find the change of VF and VI. It is going to be shown by delta V. So that is what we are able to see here. We will go to the next slide. And what I find here is the triangles, they are similar in proportion, angles are same, they are basically by angle, I mean that side angle, side test, the triangles are in the similar proportion and therefore the corresponding sides, they have to be in the same proportion. That delta R divided by R, its magnitude is equal to delta V divided by V. That's what we find. Now, I just shift the terms, that delta V upon V that V shifted here, and I find V upon R into delta R is equal to delta V, I get it as. Whereas, I actually want to find what is acceleration and I divide both sides by delta T and then I'll find it something looks like this, delta V upon delta T is equal to V upon R into delta R by delta T. So, whereas this delta V divided by delta T will give me what is my acceleration A, and this delta R divided by delta T, this delta R, because if it's very small, delta R divided by delta T is actually equal to displacement upon time, and that will also give me what is my velocity V. So, I find this becomes your velocity V, and it now is going to become V squared upon R. Is equal to this delta V by delta T is your acceleration. We will call it as centripetal acceleration. So you find centripetal acceleration is equal to V squared by R. That is how you can understand this in this form of a animation. The direction of this centripetal acceleration I will find here. I find that the direction was towards the center of the circle in the direction of delta V itself. So, you understand that centripetal acceleration acts towards the center when VI and VF, they were equal in magnitude because the motion was UCM. Whereas, if the motion is not UCM and the speed is increasing constantly, we will have this VF greater than VI. And in that case, my direction of delta V will be somewhere in this direction here. and then the direction of even your centripetal acceleration or the total acceleration, it will be here. And this total acceleration can now be composed of two things. You see, here it is. The total acceleration comes here. The part of this acceleration is centripetal, whereas the next part of acceleration, it is called as tangential acceleration. So the total acceleration in case of a particle which is performing non-uniform circular motion, that acceleration will not be pointing towards the center of the circle, whereas the total acceleration will have two different components. One is centripetal acceleration, whose value is equal to v squared by r. The other is tangential acceleration, and its value is equal to a tangential is equal to r into alpha. So if at all your acceleration is only centripetal acceleration, then in that case the body is said to perform UCM. If it is non UCM, in that case both these types of accelerations will be existing. And for every particle performing circular motion, whether it is UCM or non UCM, the centripetal acceleration is going to become must. This will always be there. Well, thank you very much for watching this video.